morning, Winnicott.
Max Patel and Cam Kelly here bringing you yet another exciting episode of WHTV.
It's been real tough, though, to get any good work done here at school recently, with so many students getting sick. We here in the studio were also not so immune.
On several occasions last week, up to 5 of our crew members were out for at least 1 or more days. Hopefully you stayed healthy and managed to avoid the zombies. Yes, Cam, I said, the zombies.
Indeed. We've got a few things for you in today's show, including a look at last week's Mr. WHS competition and a music review of a new band.
But first, there's a lot of things going on over the next week. Here's a quick look of what's up.
Tonight, there's a fundraiser for the Seabrook American Legion to help raise funds for the Cornelia de Lange syndrome, and another fundraiser tomorrow in the dining hall for multiple sclerosis. Both of these are senior seminar projects for this trimester.
If you remember last year, there was a 3v3 soccer tournament held in the memory of Laura Bunce. If you also recall, Team Ryan Dunn and I won that tournament. This year, this Sunday, the 3v3 annual tournament is being held at 9 o'clock, so be up early.
All right. Next Wednesday, JAG will be hosting a basketball shootout in the gym from 5:30 to 7:30.
What the heck is JAG, Cam?
Oh, I'm sure someone around here must know.
Jobs for American graduates.
Thank you, girls. And finally, Friday and Saturday, students will perform this year's fall's play, Arsenic and Old Lace, right here in the Winnicott Auditorium. It's coming earlier than usual this year, and for a while now, every afternoon, drama students have been making the set and rehearsing their lines. Here's a clip of the fall play. Roll it.
Just last week, on that very stage, Winnicott held its second ever Mr. WHS contest. And here's a little fun fact. Did you know that Google has 84,000 pages with high school male pageants on them? After this next story, that will be 84,001. Check out what went down.
Last Monday was the second annual Mr. WHS beauty pageant. The competition was fierce, and the contestants were truly gods among men.
So, you know, I did Mr. WHS because I think I'm a pretty awesome guy. Probably, like, top 10 in the universe. Gandhi's probably number 2 right behind me, but, I mean, he's a pretty cool guy.
This is only the second Mr. WHS. This is the second annual Mr. WHS. It started last year. It was a senior seminar project. The winner of Mr. WHS goes on to compete for Mr. Southern New Hampshire.
Good stuff.
Some of the highlights of the show were the extreme sports, costumes, and talent sections. Some of the talents blew us away. Others, well, they left us speechless. And finally, after many outrageous moments, the audience voted and Jake Martin was crowned Mr. WHS, narrowly beating Ryan Dunn by 9 votes.
So, I mean, winning's great, but I mean, let's be honest, I had this wrapped up in the bag before it even started. I had won it before I even signed up, and that's how I feel about that.
Well, congratulations to Jake Martin on his astonishing victory.
Didn't he sing Build Me Up Buttercup, Cam?
Yeah, he did, Max, and I love that song. And speaking of good songs, let's see what Frank brings you this week in his little What the Heck Is That thing. Frank, take it away.
Welcome to What the Heck Is That? I'm gonna show you stuff you didn't know about, stuff you didn't even know you didn't know about. Here's
Welcome to Mini What the Heck Is That? Mini What the Heck will let you know what's up with this and that. And today, here's the good stuff on a band whose debut CD was released last week. Straight out of Tallahassee comes Hot Chelle Rae, a power pop band with their new album, Love Sick Electric. If you like dance rock, this is the band for you. I must say, in less than 10 seconds into their debut song, it has my toes tapping. They might look like an older version of the Jonas Brothers, but they rock more like Muse, Panic at the Disco, or Cobra Starship, and the band even says they're influenced by Sheryl Crow. The weird name comes from one of their early fans, Chelle Rae. It took WHTV almost a whole fourth block to try to figure out how to even pronounce it.
Right. So, Chelle.
Yet even if you can't pronounce it, these guys are just plain fun. Give them a listen and see what you think. Here's Hot Chelle Rae's debut single, I Like to Dance. Here's something new for this week, trivia. The first 5 students to come to Mr. Roberts' room with the correct answer to this week's trivia, you will win a sticker from Hot Chelle Rae and their poster. This one is an up-and-coming band, so you might want these. The trivia question of the week is, how many calories do you burn every minute you watch TV? Do you have the answer? Well, come down to A111 and answer right away to win.
If for any reason you want to see any of our stories again, check out WHTV's YouTube channel where we post some of our segments and even full episodes.
Full episodes. That's the hookups. And if you are not already a fan, join the fan page group for WHTV now.
And don't forget Twitter, too, for sweet tweets about what's going on in the studio.
True that. But that's all for this week, Winnicunnet. We'll see you next week. I got a hair on my tongue.
And watch out for the zombies.